ice cream ready. Treat time. My profession in the regiment is I'm a captain.
Ah.
I'm an officer. And I have two things to show you.
Okay.
Everything that I would have been given to enjoy the luxury of an officer in camp, and then the luxury of everything I had out in the field.
Normally, when you're on patrol, you would not have any kind of tentage, any kind of camp furniture at all?
When I was going to be in camp, let's say, for about a week, a couple months, maybe 6 months or more, I would have the luxuries of my desk, my paperwork, anything that I had from home that I could bring along came with me.
Everything from the end of the table over would be only what you'd have in a settled camp. Basically, our wagon trains have caught up with us. We're going to be here for several weeks.
Whiskey? A little cup of drinking in? I even had the pleasure of having oil lamps.
Normally, the cavalry worked. They would set up a base of operation, and then they would patrol up from that base. For the next several weeks, they go 2 or 3 days at a time, come back, resupply, and go back out again.
So this is everything that I would have. So if you see here on the desk, right now I have my paperwork. It's very important that I keep records of pay and what soldiers are being earned every month. Most troopers earn a total of $13 a month. Now if they bought something from the quartermaster and the quartermaster wrote out the paperwork, I would receive that paperwork. Didn't have the money to purchase boots or a gun or something that they needed equipment-wise, they just deducted it from their pay.
That would be the only time you would have tentage, that would be the only time you would have furniture, and that would be the only time you would get all of the rations you were supposed to get.
This part of the exhibit here is everything that I would have to carry in this. Now this is your haversack. This is like a purse today. I have to carry everything from food to equipment if I can't get it on the horse. So, like Uber peas, the peanuts, because this had a lot of protein, but at the time they didn't realize that. It's a lot of protein. My housewife, because I was issued one uniform. 9 times out of 10, you had to fix it. And if you didn't know how to sew, you better find somebody in the unit that does. Binoculars. I have an extra hat. One of the greatest differences that we like to show kids and people that are interested in the war is when you're in camp, you have this. You have everything that you basically need, your reports, your paperwork, your books, you can have a journal if you could write. In the field, all that is replaced by something like this. Because this is the best that you can carry. If you can't get it into this, or on the bags on the saddle, 9 times out of 10, it's not going to do.
Now the A-frame tent you see over there, they very seldomly use those. Well, they were too big, too heavy to carry, and their supply wagons usually couldn't keep up with them. In the Gettysburg campaign, the 8th Illinois Cavalry was in the saddle for 14 hours a day. Another hour to take care of the horse, another, you know, half an hour, 45 minutes to prepare your meal doesn't leave for a lot of sleep. So that's why they carried the shelter half. Most often they stayed in that.
So what can you tell me about the weapons?
What I got here is like a battle.
You were issued 60 rounds of ammunition for every soul. They came pre-packaged like this. These are made, but it was actually an interesting sidelight. All over the North and South, cottage industries opened up to roll cartridges for things. They would basically contract with a local arsenal, and they tell you, we want so many thousand ones for 56 caliber, we want so many for 44s, and things like that. Because they drank coffee morning.
Where's your horse?
I don't have a horse anymore. I did, but no, they, like I say, they didn't bring them.
Well, actually, they didn't. Number one train good between the troops whenever they got together was coffee.
It was hard to
number
handle
number one or two,
sell,
depending on what you
read, was
medium.
Because
they were relations leaders, they loved to know what was going on. They found out what was happening around them. They, whenever they could get their hands on the newspaper or anything like that, they would immediately get it and could pass through the lines to get things. It didn't matter which side it was from, they would be anything they could. What's laid out on the rifle box is the trooper's personal belongings. No one trooper would have all of the things here. The only thing every trooper would have would be a housewife, because you were issued, when you enlisted, you were issued your uniform, which was their pants, was armed for a year, they lasted a couple of weeks. And if you were in the cavalry, you didn't get cavalry pants.
Sure, I shook my head, and I gazed with a feeling rare. And I says I to a passerby, who's the maid with the nut brown hair? Oh, he smiled at me with the pride, says he, that's a gem of Ireland's crown. It's a young Rose McCann from the banks of the Man, the star of the county down. Down. Oh, from Bantry Bay up the dairy. I met in the county down. At the crossroads there, I'll surely be there, and I'll dress in my Sunday clothes, with my shoes shone bright and my hat cocked right, for a smile from my nut brown rose. No pipe I'll smoke, no horse I'll yoke, till my plow turns a rust-colored brown, till the silent bride by my own fireside be the star of the county down. Over Bantry Bay, up the Derry Quay, from Galway to Dublin town, no maid I've seen like the sweet Colleen I met in the county down.
This is something that would stay more towards camp. Cigar boxes, they call them sin bins. Everybody heard the term hockey and stuff like that. Sin bins, you'd have your tobacco and any kind of cigars. You'd actually even have playing cards.
When you're on the march, the only thing you actually have with you is your bedroll, a blanket, and whatever fits in your little haversack.
What's your most important piece of equipment?
Your horse. And that's the number one rule of the cavalry. The horse is more important than you are. They cost more, they're harder to replace, they're harder to train. So you take care of the horse first.
The reason why they did that is because back then it was actually a little bit more of time than it is now. Smoking, gambling, pornography, all that stuff was really taboo. But you're away from home, you don't have your parents around, you're gonna try different things.
Tent is set up for, we just threw a few things and set up for four, which is what they were designed for. In reality, they used to sleep six, so if you look in there, you can see how crowded. We just laid out a couple of blankets and a few shirts and things, you can get the idea of it. But if you put six people in there with all of their accoutrements, including their saddles for their horses and that, you can imagine it gets pretty close and pretty tight.
Pretty much, when you look at back towards the desk, an officer is somebody that is educated. Nine times out of ten, he's either a school teacher, a lawyer, or could even be a doctor, but they were reserved for the medical corps. And the whole reason why is because he had to be able to write. Most importantly, he had to know how to read.
What the old troopers did was when they got their coffee, because they loved sweet, they would immediately mix the sugar and coffee together. And that way you always get sweet coffee. No matter how careful you are, you're going to run out of one or the other. But when they mix it together, you immediately get sweet coffee.
One of the most important things when you had the time was to actually write a letter home. This is actually a letter from one of my troopers who was wounded in an earlier battle. And he was sitting in his front parlor, decided to write the letter.
What we've laid out on the tables is the rations you're supposed to get. They knew nothing about nutrition, they knew nothing about calories or that, they just knew they needed to fill you up.
The Camptown ladies sing the song tonight.
This is actually 10 ounces of beans. If you got peas for the day, it was any of the horses. You either got rice or beans or peas or hominy, whatever was available at the time. You got them dried like this. Absolutely useless to get on the march.
These
are for ponies or something. The peas, the beans are getting a little bit. They're getting soft, but they will not be usable for at least 5 or 6 more hours. The peas are a lot longer away from that, so they're useless to eat here on the march and the things on. You got rice or hominy. Because we're in the Cavalry and our horses got oats and barley, they share it with us. The most nutritious thing on the table is the oats, which is not part of the rations, but you can use it. It was also one of the few things you got that you could actually cook when you're on the thing. If you can boil water, you can make your rations. What you actually got all the time and the only thing you were guaranteed to get was your bread ration. In camp, you actually did get fresh bread a lot of times, and a lot of people surprised at that, but baked bread was one of the essentials that they considered. You had to have bread all the time. So you get, this is actually a light loaf, that the military loaf would have been about 3 ounces, 4 ounces heavier, and you got one of them a day when you were in camp. If you were on the march, you got hardtack, hard bread, army bread. 10 of these is equal to a pound. So when they came, you were basically got that. Your main weapon was that this is a Sharp's carbine. It's a cavalry weapon. It is much shorter than the infantry weapon and several pounds lighter. If you've ever been able to see the troops, they're pulling out their cartridge out of their cartridge box, bite the top off, pour it in. They bite the ball off, hold the ball, they mouth pour the powder in, spit the ball in, crumble the paper up, ram it home, fix it, recover the weapon, put a cap on, and then they're ready to go. This is a breech loader. It was the high, this was high tech in 1863. Went to half cock, you dropped the breech, you took your cartridge out, shoved it in. This is Sharp. It acts as a guillotine. It chops the pigtail off the end of the cartridge, allows the powder in. You put your cap on, and you're ready to fire.
All right. Thank you.
A well-trained trooper will get 6 to 7 shots off in a minute versus 3 shots for infantry. They have the advantage in distance. They're accurate for about 500 yards effective range. This is effective range 250 and 300 accurate for about 400 yards. But while they're getting 3 shots off, you're getting 7 shots off. They also fought different tactics than that, which made this more thing. Thank you.